garage, please. Car's ready to leave. One lap of fuel remaining.
qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. Surfer Girl, Hulkenberg, and Sergio Perez. Goodbye for now then, really, we're just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. Welcome once again then to the United States Grand Prix here in the magnificent city of Austin. It was here in 2018 that Kimi Raikkonen delighted the world by taking the top step of the podium for the first time in 114 races. There's always a record to be broken, so what, I wonder, is in store for us here today? We're racing then today in Travis County, Texas, around the 20 corners of this wonderful Circuit of the Americas. We'll be reaching speeds of around 200 miles per hour here today, and there are plenty of good opportunities to pass, especially through the two DRS zones into Turn 1 and the long back straight into Turn 12. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Surfer Girl lines up on pole position, and Nico Hülkenberg completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Verstappen, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Norris, Russell, Sainz, Fernando Alonso, and Daniel Ricciardo. Perez, they've taken a grid penalty. Mick Schumacher, Esteban Ocon, and Bottas. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Tsunoda, Vettel, Lance Stroll, and Guan Yu Zhou. Gasly, they've taken a grid penalty. Magnussen, Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? And joining me again for the race today, Natalie Pinkham. Now let's talk about Sergio Perez. Looks like they have a tough race in store today, as grid penalties from changing power unit components has forced them further down the field.
But on the bright side, at least those fresh components can help them maintain the power they need to come through the pack. I expect to see them take a much more aggressive approach today to make up for that compromised start.
Formation lap gets underway, and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for battle once the lights go out. So as all the cars reform the grid, the drivers will be hoping to get a strong start. They'll want to win some valuable points from today's race, with final communications being done with their race engineers, ensuring the planned strategies are all in place.
Okay, our main competitors in this race are Hülkenberg and Leclerc. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. Radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Dries definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Okay, one stop to go, just one stop left in this strategy. You've got four laps until your pit window opens. Well done. The fastest lap at this point in time is a 1 minute 40.7. position, front of the pack. And that's Nico behind. Our gap behind is 1.1 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. Okay, your pit window opens next lap. Okay, we're into the last 10 laps now. Officials have deployed the safety car due to multiple cars being stopped on track. Mind your delta. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, Nico's into the pits. Nico in the pits. Copy that. Okay, we're coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. In this lap, you're in control of the pace as we start. Keep it steady until the safety cars reach the pit lane. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on driving. Our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops, let's go. Back, that's last place. Gasly's ahead of you, and gap to the car in front is 7.9 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Okay, just 5 laps until the end. Have the data for that request. The drivers we're fighting here are Gasly and Stroll. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. Okay, gap ahead is 3.9 seconds. Caution. Green flag. Turbochargers on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Brilliant. Nice move. Keep going. But remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. Seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in first. Time last lap was a 1:42.2. first. And the time last lap was a 1:42.3. If you continue to cut corners, the stewards are going to give you a penalty. Alright, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
That's a spectacular victory, and with it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. Wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Today, I think I'll give it to the Haas driver.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are the Formula One world champions. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, that was certainly an exciting weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for more exciting Formula One action very soon.